Hello there! Today, I am so excited to be doing a book haul. And I'm so excited that November 1st is over. I know some of you have been there, or were there. November 1st is college application day. Early decision day. So most of my October was spent writing essays and editing videos for college submission. It was a good experience that I just don't want to talk about right now. Today I have some really exciting books to haul. There have been some really awesome new releases. We just have a lot to talk about. This first book came out very recently. It is Humans of New York Stories by Brandon Stanton. Of course, we all know Humans of New York, the blog. If you don't, definitely something you want to be liking on Facebook. It's really just a book of photos of people and their stories and very brief interviews and even just like one sentence statements that let you in on their lives. Really powerful photos. I like this one even better than the original book. The next book I have is possibly the most exciting one because it's freaking Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, the complete illustrated edition. I have had so much fun reading this. When I first bought it, I started flipping through it and I was stopped, thankfully. Don't flip through this book because you have to experience it, reading it chapter by chapter, a little bit at a time. I love re-experiencing the first book, which I haven't read since second grade, and the illustrations are amazing. Next, of course, we have Magnus Chase and the Gods of Asgard. I'm so upset that I haven't gotten a chance to read this book yet. Obviously, this is the new series by Rick Riordan, author of Percy Jackson. I have heard nothing but amazing things about Magnus Chase so far. I'm so excited to learn more about Norse mythology and get into another world of Rick Riordan. All in the same release date, we have Life and Death by Stephanie Meyer, Twilight Reimagined. We've all heard of it by now. I didn't realize when I went to buy it that it was Twilight 10th Anniversary Edition and this in one. It's interesting. I've talked to a few people who have read it, and they were surprised that it was literally Twilight, almost line by line, with just like a few things changed. I believe it. It's also been a long time since I've read Twilight. There's been some good discussion that has come out of this. I was a huge Twilight fan. I think it was fifth grade when I read the series, which is, it's super weird that I was 10 and reading Twilight. I was known as Twi-Guy in fifth grade. Oh God. I'm having flashbacks. My first email address was TwiGuy. Okay. The next book I have to show you is Carry On by Rainbow Rowell. Carry On is the story of Simon and Boz from Fangirl. It's been too long since I've read a Rainbow Rowell book. I'm so happy that this exists and I'm so ready for it. One of the books I'm currently reading is The Martian by Andy Weir. I don't know if I'm pronouncing his name correctly. I don't know if I've ever heard it. I've been listening to the audiobook version of this, and now that I'm about 40 pages in, probably, it's really picked up. I, of course, picked it up because of the movie, but I love the story. I don't know if I'll finish it by the time the movie leaves theaters. This has been really interesting to listen to because it's very Castaway. This one guy is just by himself, and it's just really his thoughts. If you are interested in listening to The Martian, you could get it for free through Audible. I will leave my link down in the description. You will get a free audiobook, and it will really help out my channel. The next book I have is Black Widow Forever Red by Margaret Stoll. This book just came out in October through Marvel. I am so excited that Margaret Stoll has a new book. I really enjoyed her writing in Beautiful Creatures, and the main characters in Black Widow Forever Red sound fantastic. If you haven't heard about Black Widow Forever Red or Margaret Stoll, there's a lot of good stuff going on with this book right now. The first few chapters that I've read so far, it's amazing, it's fast-paced, and it's a really exciting new writing style for Margaret Stoll that I am really excited about getting into. This next book I have bought, read, and finished since my last book haul, but I just have to mention it here before I review it. I know, I'm gonna review it. It is More Happy Than Not by Adam Silvera. I read this book so quickly. I don't want to say too much about it. I'm going to make a whole video, but this is the best book I have read all year. And I was also lucky enough to interview Adam a few weeks ago, so I will be posting a review and an interview very soon with a giveaway. So if you haven't heard about this book yet, it just went on the New York Times bestseller list. It's fantastic and you're missing out. I can't even begin to describe what it's about, honestly. The next book I have is Library of Souls by Ransom Riggs. This is the third and final book in the Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children trilogy. I have had so much fun with this series, and I'm so excited to get into the final book. There have just been too many new releases, if that's possible, to keep up with some of, like, my favorite series. How am I supposed to choose between Magnus Chase, this, Harry Potter, new Twilight book? The next book I have is The Wild Ones by C. Alexander London, or as you probably know him, Alex London, author of The Proxy Duology. Proxy was one of my favorite books last year, and Alex London is such a nice guy, and I love his writing, his personality. He was in a video with me last year. He just did one of the 39 Clues books, and I'm so excited about his upcoming middle grade endeavors because this looks so unique and so interesting. The next book I have is another new release, but it's not a fiction one. It is Binge by Tyler Oakley. This is Tyler Oakley's truthful, honest, raw memoir, and it really is. I've read a lot of this book, and there's some pretty good stuff in here. I love the cover, the whole thing. A few weeks ago, I went to a really exciting event through Anderson's Bookshop, the YA Fandom Frenzy. So a few books I picked up and got signed there. The first of them is Six of Crows by Leigh Bardugo, who had a huge line and was super nice to every single person. And this sounds like such an amazing action-adventure heist book. I also picked up Catherine Howe's The Appearance of Annie Van Sinderen. The main reason I picked it up was because it follows this guy who's a film student at NYU, and I'm working on it. But of course the story sounds great too, but that's what sold me. Catherine Howe wrote Conversion last year. She was so nice, and it was so great to talk to her. And this next book I had not even heard of before I went. It's a novel told entirely in lists. So it's like reading an Ellen Hopkins book when you can have the satisfaction of reading a gigantic freaking book, but you could go through it really quickly, and it is Me Being Me is Exactly as Insane as You Being You by Todd Hassick Lowy. And this really just follows the life of this teenage boy, Darren, and a lot of crazy stuff goes down, all in list form. While I was there, I also got Another Day by David Levithan signed, and I made a video with David about Another Day, so that will be up along with a review sometime in the next couple of months. I was also lucky enough to make a video with Michael Grant, author of Frontlines. I know, there's a lot of author interviews coming out pretty soon. Michael Grant has gone a completely different direction with his writing. You know that he wrote one of my favorite series, the Gone series, and this is an alternate history novel. It takes place during World War II and follows these female soldiers. That's about all I know about it. It comes out in January, and I'm so excited about this new series, and that is about all I have for the book haul today. Thanks for watching. I have so many great author interviews and book reviews coming up. It's going to be a good holiday season on BookTube this year. Let me know what's going on with you if you're applying to college this year. Good luck. I'm there with you. And what new release are you excited about? Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys very soon. Goodbye.